how to identify that there is a hamstring tightness? Like if you just sit down straight like that, if your hamstrings are the posterior structures are very tight, what is going to happen is when you bend forward, the bending will be only at the upper back here. So bending will happen, you'll be able to touch or come up to here by bending only the dorsal spine. Whereas if your hamstrings are quite flexible, so they are quite lengthy enough, so then you'll be able to bend forward. So if keeping that whole leg straight, you just have to keep the legs, the torso straight, the chest straight, and then you try to bend it. Then if you are able to bend, that means your hamstrings are in a flexible position. So if they are tight, you cannot bend. So if someone is bending in the dorsal spine, that means the hamstrings are tight. So keeping the torso straight, and if you are able to bend, that means your hamstrings are more flexible. So if you are able to bend with the torso straight, your hamstrings are very flexible. This is a test that you can make, or you can do it yourself, and you'll see whether your hamstrings are tight or not. So this is the way of stretching. This is a method of stretching the hamstring. Now you've got to keep one leg downwards. So why do we keep the leg downwards? So that is mainly to stabilize the spine. So otherwise, if you just keep both of them above, both of them together, there is a more chance that you'll be bending in the spine rather than the hip. You are supposed to bend at the hip, not at the spine. Now for that, you keep one leg downwards, and then keep the full torso straight, so spine straight, and then try to bend forward, and you should be able to feel the pain here. Now hamstrings are the posterior structures. There are two, one which is on the outer side, one which are on the inside, that is lateral, outer hamstrings and the inner hamstrings. Both have to be stretched. How to stretch it? So you can either bring your leg outwards and then keep stretching. So by keeping the leg in the neutral position, that is in the center, what the picture is showing, so you are stretching both medial, inside and outside one. So if you are putting it outside, so you are stretching the medial one. So you should be able to feel the pain on the medial side of the thing. So then you just shift the leg to the inner side, and then when you stretch it out, you should be able to feel the stretch on the outer side of the thing. And when you are in the center, you'll be stretching both the medial as well as the lateral. So that is how you stretch the hamstring by stabilizing the pelvis. So how do you stabilize the pelvis? Keep one leg down, dangling down, and then stretch with one by one, one leg at a time. So other leg, right leg is dangling down. So that will keep the pelvis stabilized, and you'll be stretching only the hamstrings. So you will not injure your spine. So this is if you have a very severely contracted, or so it has become very tight. So many times what will happen, patients start developing arthritis. Arthritis is the joint becomes wear and tear. So wear and tear means what? It's like a tire. So tire has got ridges on the edges. So when the tire becomes worn, so the whole of that, it will become like a bald tires. So the ridges goes off. And you might be, if it is very long standing or it is balded too much, you might see even the threads inside. So when that happens, the bone gets exposed, and that is the cause for the pain. When the bones are exposed, you start developing pain and the swelling of the structure of the knee joint. The water gets filled up in the knee joint. The synovial fluid gets filled up. So for that, what we have to do, we have got to balance the hamstrings and the quadriceps. So in the initial phases, when the pain is very severe, you may not be able to isolatedly stretch the quadriceps. So how we can do it? So you can do some kind of a hydrotherapy using water. So you just stretch it out. So keep the legs down. Other leg is dangling downwards so that the pelvis is stabilized. Then put the water inside. So make it into a lukewarm water. You can put some salt also so that the inflammatory process comes down to some extent. Then, so run the this one. So once it is running, that means you just bend forward. When you are bending forward, you are stretching the hamstring. Then take the water and then pour it here. So that means the whole thing is becoming stretched. So when you are bending forward, you are stretching. So once that is done, the pain becomes lesser. So that is hamstring stretching. And you are also increasing. And you tighten your thigh. So keep it tight. This is press it down. So thigh muscle, front muscle is getting strengthened. So it is becoming stronger and stronger. So 5 times or 10 times you can do. So after that, this straight leg. So this weight of this limb, you just try to rise it out. Rise it from the bed in front. So rise that, hold for a few seconds and then come down. So rise it and hold. So this will be for strengthening of the front muscle. So bending forward is for stretching of the back muscle. The lifting up is for the strengthening of the front muscles. So by this, we are strengthening the quadriceps muscle. We are stretching the hamstring muscle and trying to get the balance in the front and the back muscle so that the joint becomes more stable and the wear and tear will come down. So that's how we can prevent the early onset of degeneration in your knee joint. It's a very simple procedure. So this used to be done in the previous, in our earlier generation, where they used to churn the grains using the stones. So they used to put some grains in that and then keep on moving. So one leg would be straight and other leg would be folded. And then just bend forward for the grinding. So this used to automatically stretch the hamstrings. So that's how those earlier people, the previous generation, elderly, they never used to have this kind of arthritis. Because the work itself was allowing them to have a balanced knee joint. But nowadays, as we are sitting like this for a very long time, so we are developing all these arthritis at a very early age. So try always to balance them by doing this simple procedures which can help you in preventing the early onset of osteoarthritis in your knee joint. So this is strengthening exercises, then strengthening against the gravity weight, that is straight leg raising exercises. So this will strengthen your quadriceps and bending forward will stretch your hamstrings and balance the knee joint. So today we have learnt about the problems which are very commonly seen secondary to the positions like that which we are keeping when you are working on the computer for a very long duration. It's a very bad posture. So regularly we have got to stretch it out, strengthen the muscles of the foot and ankle, to stretch the quadriceps muscle or your calf muscle, strengthen the front muscles and the back muscles in the leg, then stretch the posterior muscle, the hamstring muscle, by doing all those exercises. So whenever the tissues are stretched like this for a long time, that muscle is going to become weak. So strengthen the quadriceps muscle by a straight leg raise, and you can lift it up even with the weight in the leg also. So stretching and the strengthening will balance the joint and the degeneration would be prevented, or so it becomes later onset. So you will be preventing the early onset of arthritis.